any dinner is made better with any kind of beef. I think of grass-fed and conventional like iPhone and Android. They're two different products, but the market has enough room for both types of products. One's not necessarily better than the other, they're just different products. My name is James O'Brien. I'm a seventh generation rancher from Beeville, Texas. Well, the beef has to come from somewhere. It doesn't come from HEB. We've got these herds out here to try to responsibly raise high quality beef. There are more similarities between conventional and grass-fed than there are differences. A conventional calf isn't fed corn their whole life. A conventional calf spends just as much time on grass for the first two-thirds of their lives as a grass-fed calf does. And then the finishing process, which is the last 3 to 6 months, conventional calves are on grain, grass-fed calves are still on grass. We've been down here since the 1830s, and grass-fed seems new and trendy, but raising a steer on grass, finishing that product, and selling it to your neighbors is real nostalgic, and it's real fulfilling, and it's something that people have been doing for a long time. We're still primarily cow-calf, but we added the grass-fed because it's something we can do together as a family. We're always looking for new opportunities to diversify the business and make a good living. Our conventional process is not as conventional as a lot of places. We don't supplement with feed on the conventional side or the grass-fed side because we focus on forage production in the pasture. We don't throw grain at our conventional herd because we've got too many to feed. The biggest challenge is room whenever you're trying to finish cattle on grass. We've got herds in different places and it's important for them to have enough room so that places don't get overgrazed. I like to make the joke that I didn't turn into a grass-fed beef producer, I turned into a grass farmer. We work hard to manage these pastures, create good forage quality so that we can have a higher efficiency and be able to put more cattle in the same place without any negative effects on the pasture or the environment. All of our cattle have Brahman influence in them somewhere. South Texas is rough country, and the Brahman breed in general is just a real hardy breed. It's hard to find something that can still be fat and fleshy and good looking when it's 110 outside and there's more brush than grass. You'll hear people call it first cross or F1 or hybrid vigor, which is a breeding tactic to emphasize the positive traits of both breeds. The biggest challenge on a daily basis is the laundry list of fires to put out during the day while we're trying to focus on the big picture at the same time. And so while I'm fixing a fence or checking a cow that's down or water pipe that's busted, I've also got to consider the fact that we've got to get off the farm and ranch and get involved with policy making and then still spend time at home with my wife and kids. I think the Western lifestyle hits home for me because that's how I was raised. It's important to us to keep that tradition alive, but also to have a sustainable business and to be able to make a living. We're excited about being able to provide a product raised by a family and sold to our neighbors that people are excited about.